So today we're going to be working on Eureka Module 5, Lesson 6. So let's go ahead and get started. So our objective today is we're going to use that associative property to subtract from three-digit numbers, and we can also verify solutions with addition. What that means is we're going to be using our strategy from Lesson 5, and we're going to be making hundreds to make subtraction a little easier for us. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, before we begin, let's go ahead and start with an application problem. Maria made 60 cupcakes for the school bake sale. She sold 28 cupcakes on the first day. How many cupcakes did she have left? I'm going to go ahead and use a tape diagram for this. So you could see our whole is 60 because she had 60 altogether, and then she sold part of them. She sold 28, and we want to figure out how many she had left. So let's go ahead and look at the number bond. We have 60 on top, that's the whole. Part is 28. We've got to figure out the other part. So I can do that with subtraction. So I'm going to go ahead and use an arrowway. I'm going to start at 60 and I'm going to just start subtracting. So I'm going to look at my number 28 and it has two tens. So I'm going to take away 20. I could do that in my head. So that is 40. And then I'm looking at my ones. How many ones do I have? I have 8 ones, so 40 take away 8. I know that 10 take away 8 is 2, so 40 take away 8 is 32. So 60 take away 28 equals 32. So there are 32 cupcakes left over. All right, so let's go ahead and step into our concept today. So I have some cubes that I want you to look at. On the top, I have 5 cubes, and on the bottom, I have 8 cubes. So I'm going to go ahead and put those numbers right next to them. And the question I have for you is, what is the difference? So if you look right there, we can find the difference by kind of finding the extra. When I have the red cubes, I want to find the extra on the other side. So what is the difference right there? Can you count those for me? So the difference is 3. And I can use a subtraction sentence to tell me that 8 take away 5 is equal to 3. Okay, let's try another one now. Now you can see I have the same 5 yellow cubes, but I'm adding one more. So that means I have 6 on top. And then on the bottom, I have the same 8 cubes. I have 5 yellow and 3 red, so 8, but I added one green. So now I have 9 altogether. So I have a question for you. What is the difference? Well, if I look at the difference right there, the difference is still the same. I have 1, 2, 3 red cubes. So let's go ahead and look at the number sentence for that. 9 take away 6 is equal to 3. Okay, let's compare those side by side. When we compare our cubes together, they kind of look the same. So let's go ahead and look at the differences in the two. Okay, I have 3 on that side and 3 on the other side. Now the cubes are almost the same, except on this side, I added one more. Did the difference change? No, it didn't change at all. It stayed the same. Okay, so let's go ahead and continue. I'm going to take those same cubes, and now I'm going to pretend that each cube represents a 10. So it's not just one, it's a 10. So let's go ahead and just look at the cubes on the bottom. I have 5 yellow cubes, so that's 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. I have 50 on the bottom, and let's look on the top. I have 5 yellow and 3 red, so that means I have 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 on the top. Okay, so what is the difference? Remember, each cube is a 10. Well, I'm going to go ahead and show you a new strategy. I'm going to show you how to make like these linking cubes, but we're going to pretend that they're tape diagrams now. So on the bottom, I have 50, and on the top, I have 80. Okay, so what's the difference? Well, if I make a number sentence, it's 80 take away 50, and the difference is 30. So you can see on the top with cubes, the difference is 30, and on the bottom, the difference is 30. So we're going to start moving into the tape diagram instead of those cubes. But for now, let's go ahead and keep on keeping on with the cubes. And I have 5 yellow cubes, and now I added a green. So remember, each cube is worth 10. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and 60. And then let's look at the cubes on top. I had 5 yellow and 3 red, so I had 80. And then if I add 10 more, that is 90. So what is the difference there? Remember, each cube counts as 10. So let's count those red cubes. 10, 20, and 30. The difference is still 30. So now let's go ahead and make this into a tape diagram. Now remember, I started with 80. I had 80 on top and I had 50 on the bottom. And then I added 10. That green is my 10. And then I added 10 more to the top. So if I make a number sentence to show this, on the top I have 10 plus 80, so that's equal to 90, and then I have 10 plus 50, and that's equal to 60. So 90 take away 60 equals 30. The difference is still the same. So now let's go ahead and go into a number bond. Remember we started with 80 and 50, and then we said the difference was 30? Well, on the next problem we had 90 and 60, and then we said the difference was 30. So when you looked at those cubes, when I had the cubes lined up, if I added some to the top and if I added some to the bottom, it didn't matter. As long as you added the same amount, the difference stayed the same. So let's go ahead and look at a number sentence for this. We have 90 take away 60, and that is equal to 80 take away 50. Now remember, the equal sign doesn't mean an answer. The equal sign means the same as. So remember, it's kind of like a seesaw. It has to balance. So another way to say equals is the same as. So we can say 90 take away 60 is the same as 80 take away 50, and that is the same as, and that's where we can put our answer, and that's 30. So all of those are equal, and if we lined them all up on a seesaw, they would all balance. Okay, let's go ahead and look at our first problem. We have 34 take away 19. So I'm going to go ahead and make a tape diagram for this, and I have 34 and I have 19 on the bottom. Now I'm looking at this problem and it's not very easy. I have a 9, I have a 4. I don't really see any friendly numbers, but can we make a friendly number? We can make a friendly number. Do you see that 19? That's really close to 20. So to find the difference, let's just make a friendly number. So I'm going to add 1 to that 19, because if I add 1 to that 19, that makes it nice and easy, and now it's a 20. And then remember, what I do to the bottom, I have to do to the top, no matter what. You have to do the same, so that way the difference is the same. So what do you think I'm going to do to the top? I'm going to add 1 more. So now, instead of having 34 take away 19, my new number sentence is 35 take away 20. Is that a little easier to work with? Well, I know I have 3 tens and I'm taking away 2 tens, so that just leaves me with 1 10, and then I have 5 ones, so my answer is 15. So do you see how I was able to talk my way through it and make my subtraction problem a little easier by using this strategy? Okay, so let's go ahead and continue. Now I have the problem 230 take away 180. Let's go ahead and figure that out. Ooh, but this is a little tricky. Even though I have some tens, they're not like friendly tens, like to where it's like 100 by itself, right? So let's go ahead and look at this problem. 250 take away 200. Can we solve that one in our heads? Well, yeah, because 250 take away 200, if I just take away all the hundreds, I'm left with 50. I can do that problem in a snap, just like that. That's how easy it is. So how can we make the first problem like the second problem? Well, let's go ahead and start off with a tape diagram, okay? Remember, I'm looking at the first problem on top, 230 take away 180. So I have my tape diagram, I have 230 take away 180. Remember, if I add some to the top and bottom to make friendly numbers, my difference will stay the same. So which number is close to the next 100? Well, I have that 180. So, you know, I'm going to change my tape diagram up, and now my tape diagram is going to look like that. So let's go ahead and put my numbers in there again. And I'm looking at that 180, and I can make that a nice, friendly, juicy 100 number. So I have 180, and I'm going to add 20 to that. Because if I add 20 to 180, that gives me the next 100. And that next 100 is 200. Now let's look at 230. Okay. I'm going to do the same thing to that number because I have to. That's the rule. If you make a friendly number on the bottom by adding 20, I have to add 20 to the top. So 230 plus 20 is 250. So would you look at that? Now I have 250 take away 200, and I already solved that number sentence in my head. It equals 50. So that means that 230 take away 180 is also equal to 50. So remember, it's the same problem, just written different ways. What we're trying to do is find the difference. So if we use this strategy, it helps us make subtraction a little easier. Okay, let's go ahead and do some checking with that problem, right? I started with 230 take away 180, and we know that equals 50 because we just solved it. And then the easier problem was 250 take away 200, and that also equaled 50. The difference was the same. Now let me show you why this strategy is a little easier. If I write the top problem in the algorithm that we all like to use, well, look right here. My ones, I'd be able to put a zero, but here I have a 3 on the top and an 8 down below. That means I would have to go next door and unbundle and do those types of things. So if you know how to use this strategy and you make a friendly number, well, you don't have to go next door or anything like that. If you look at it written vertically, it makes the problem nice and simple. So when we add the same amount to both numbers, we call this compensation. I've been saying this is our new strategy, but this is the compensation strategy. So now that we have a name for it, let's go ahead and try the compensation strategy to another problem. So I have 330 take away 280. So let's go ahead and put this problem into a tape diagram. So there we are with 330 and 280. Okay, now I want to make a friendly number. So I'm going to change my tape diagram. So now my tape diagram looks like this. Now I'm still going to put the same numbers in. I have 330, 280, but let's think. What can we add to these numbers to make 100? So that way we just have to subtract an even number that's 100. Okay, so let's see. I have 280 and 80 is close to the next 100. So what do you think I'm going to do to that problem? 80, 90, 100. So that's the next 100. So if I add 20 more, I'll have 300. Now remember, what I do to the bottom, I must do to the top. So I'm going to add 20 there. So what's 330 plus 20? Well, that is 350. So now instead of my number sentence looking like this, now my number sentence looks like this, 350 take away 30. Remember, the difference will still be the same, but we just made our subtraction problem a little easier to do in our head. So let's go ahead and think. We have 350 and we take away 300. Let's take away all those hundreds and we're left with 50. And remember, this is the compensation strategy, and that helped make our subtraction a little easier, and we were able to kind of do it in our heads instead of having to unbundle when we're doing the algorithm. Okay, let's go ahead and continue. The next problem is 321 take away 199. Well, here is my tape diagram, 321 take away 199. Now you're noticing that I have some ones now. I don't just have tens. So I can still use the compensation strategy when I don't have tens. So I'm looking at that number 199, and that is really close to 200. How many do I need to add to that to make it our next 100? Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to change my tape diagram because I know I want my tape diagram to look like this. I'm going to add something to the top and bottom to make some friendly numbers. So there's the same numbers in my number sentence, but to that 199, I'm just going to add one more and that'll give me 200. And then we have to do the same to the top. So that gives me 300, not 21, 22. So now we have a new number sentence and I can do that in my head. 300s take away 200s is 100. And then I have 22 ones. So my answer is 122. So listen to how I'm going to read this number sentence. 321 take away 199 is the same as 322 take away 200. And that is the same as 122. All right, and again, this is the compensation strategy. Now, remember, you can also check your problem with addition. So let me show you how to do that. We're going to be looking at this problem right here. 322 take away 200 is equal to 122. And this is where it's kind of like a fact family, right? So here's our big long number sentence again, and we're going to check this one right here. If I take my answer and I add it to one of the add-ins, and I'm going to pick 200 because that's the easiest add-in to use, you're going to see that my answer is still 322. So remember, we kind of have those number bonds and those fact families, and as long as all those numbers work together, you can use this strategy. All right, so let's try one more. I have 514 take away 290. Again, I'm going to go ahead and write my tape diagram, 514 take away 290. And remember, we're going to make friendly numbers. So let's get rid of this tape diagram and let's get one that looks like this. So I'm going to put my numbers in and I'm looking at that 290 and I want to make that a friendly number. So how do I get to my next 100? 90. 100, I need to add 10. So let's go ahead and add 10. And then I'm going to do the same on top because that's the rule. What I do on the bottom, I have to do on the top. What I do on the top, I have to do on the bottom. I have to do the same to both numbers for my compensation strategy. So 514 plus 10, that is 524. And now I have 300 on the bottom. So can you do that in your head? Go ahead and think about that for a second. 524 take away 300. What is that? 524, I have 500s, let's take away three of those. That leaves me with 200s and 24 ones. So 224, and remember you can also check that with addition. And that is it. So I'm going to go ahead and walk you through two problems in our problem set. So let's go ahead and get started on those. Okay, this is your first problem. It says, draw and label the tape diagram to show how to simplify the problem. Write the new equation and then subtract. So we have 220 take away 190. So you can see our tape diagram here. We have 220 and then we have 190. So we added 10 to each of them to make an easier equation. So what is that answer? All you have to do is put in that answer for me. Okay, and this is our second problem, 320 take away 190. So again, here's the tape diagram on the bottom, and then you have your simplified equation, and I want your answer. Now remember, this is just a strategy. If you don't feel comfortable with this strategy, that's okay. We will have more strategies for you to use. So remember, math allows thinking to happen. So try this strategy out, and if you like it, it's something that you can use for the rest of your life. If you don't like it, well, you learn something new and you can move on to the next strategy and find something that works for you. And that's all for today. Bye.